Tonight on Be Something Wonderful, how to practice mindfulness without meditating. This is Tom Karen with the Be Something Wonderful studio of Higher Consciousness, where we help you level up and become the best version of yourself. Welcome back, creators. Got a great lesson tonight. This is based on a book called Mindful Manifestation, and the author is Tim Grimes, although he writes about using the Neville Goddard technique. So it's really Neville Goddard's work with Tim Grimes talking about how to be mindful without meditating. Really fascinating. Want to hit this tonight because it goes along with what we've been talking about quite a bit. And here's the deal, guys. Meditation is good. Nothing against meditation. I know I've talked about it a little bit. And the idea of meditation is to get into that relaxed state, right? But it's an alert state. It's relaxed, but alert. And as thoughts come, you just let them float by. You don't judge them as good or bad. You're going to have positive ones and negative ones. And you're trying to, the whole idea of a meditation is trying to get beyond thought. It's great. If you can get beyond all thought, beyond the ego, and touch into that Christ state, that God state, that unconditional awareness, that's really where you want to be. If you could be in that most of the time, boy, you would be feeling very, very good. That's where truth is. That's where love is. But most of the time in meditation, you're just watching those thoughts go by. Tim's, it isn't a criticism. He's just saying that he spent years doing that, and all that he did, and that it was always the same experience. He would have some good thoughts and some bad thoughts, and they would go by, right, without judging them. So his point is, his other way of saying being mindful, another way of being mindful, is that you want to feel good, right? I mean, the whole idea, guys, is feeling. So forget about thoughts in with this mindful technique. Being mindful should be about feeling good. The thing about traditional meditation, you're still in your head, right? You're still in your head. We're really... Where does creation come from? Creation comes from the heart, that connection to the metaphysical space, to the divine, to the field of infinite possibilities. So it's how you feel is the language of that space, not how you think. So instead of mindfully observing thoughts without judging them, traditional meditation, he advocates, which is great, this is based on the teachings of Neville Goddard, feeling. We already have what we desire. That feels good, right? It really, guys, it's feeling is everything, right? Thoughts are not unimportant, those set intentions. And certainly, if you can get beyond all thought and get into that space where it's just that deep love, that's where you want to be. But if we want to manifest the life we want while we're in the physical space, we want to create and manifest our desires and what we want out of it, whether it's a love relationship, whether it's more money, whether it's a promotion, whether it's creating our own business, whether it's getting traveling the world, whether it's getting better at some of our hobbies or some of the things that we'd like to do. Whatever it is, it all gets down to feeling good or feeling that we already have it. This is the idea. This is how to be mindful, to really attract what you want. You've got to feel that you already are it. This is Neville Goddard, right? This is the teachings of Neville Goddard. Imagine, assume, and feel your desires as real. This is Tim's idea of mindfulness. I love it, right? Because it's right in line with Neville Goddard, and it's really what we want, right? Even if your goal is not a physical manifestation, but a mental one where you want to feel happy. Well, what does a happy feel like? What are some of the things you need to imagine for that, right? This is the idea. It feels good to feel good. I've talked about this, right? It feels good to have what we want, to think we have what we want. It feels good to know that we already have it, right? This is the wish already fulfilled. Wish fulfilled. So you've got to come from that wish fulfilled state, right? This is Neville Goddard. What does it feel like to already have what you want? Who would you be talking to? What's the conversations, right? What would you be celebrating? Imagining that, right? Imagination, after all, is that God power. That is the metaphysical space. So you could sit there and meditate and watch your thoughts go by, negative, positive, or you can get into the space where you use your imagination, that Christ consciousness, which is that God in you, which is that that field of infinite possibilities. That's the quantum field, or what Greg Branding calls the divine matrix, that energy. That's where you want to get to, right? And I like Tim's viewpoint, because he's always saying relaxing is the key. This is right in line with typical meditation, but that's mindfulness. Feeling your way to how you want to feel, or to what you want, right? Because it feels good to have what you already want. And so you can have that by getting into that meditative state or mindful state of wish already fulfilled. That's the meditative state you want to be. It's like prayer, right? It's like praying. That's the way to pray as well. Praying that you already have it. That's just what the Bible says, right? If you believe that you that you receive it, then you shall have it. You should already have it, right? If you believe, if you have faith, right? This is what the Bible says over and over again. If you have faith in it, then you will already have received it. So this is the idea, guys. Love this. So if you struggle in meditation, if you struggle with it, and sometimes you feel worse after meditating, which is not what you want, right? But you feel worse. Why? Because a negative thought comes up and you go, oh my God, I'm panicking. I'm not supposed to have negative thoughts. I'm supposed to watch them, let them go by, but I can't. I'm hanging on to it. Guys, forget all that. Right? If you can meditate and feel good about it and quiet the mind, this is good. That's good. But we take all of this much too seriously. Right? It's all about being connected to the joy. Everything's about joy. Right? The things we move around in life and we collect and the businesses we do and whether we're in our measurement of success and all of that and money passing hands, all that's good. It's activity, but that doesn't last. None of that. Now, all that good, when you make your transition, none of that matters, right? You're not going to take, your body's not going to make it. You're not going to take that with you. None of that matters. What matters is getting to that mindful state now, feeling good now, right? And if feeling that your wish is already fulfilled makes you feel good, then do that. And then detach from it. Don't get attached to it, thinking, oh my God, it isn't here. That's where worry comes in, right? The whole idea of attachment, detachment, is setting the intention, feeling your wish already fulfilled, and then letting it go. Just be in that feeling. Don't start worrying that you don't see it in physical manifestation. That's what it means by detaching, right? Detach from the worry. Don't be concerned whether it comes or not. You already got the feeling. That's what the whole idea was, to feel good anyway. Okay, guys, so this is what I wanted to talk about today. This is how to practice mindfulness without meditating. Don't make it such a big deal. We're spiritual beings, right? We were born spiritual into this physical world, right? That's our natural state. It's only really just getting back into your natural state, right? This ego body and all of this stuff, that's the unnatural, right? So it's only getting back to what's natural, right? Don't take it too, don't beat yourself up on negative thoughts. And this whole idea is, when you focus on what you want as wish already fulfilled, how can you feel negative about that, right? And guys, having negative thoughts is not a bad thing anyway, right? It shows what you do want. It gives you a sign that if you're feeling bad, or you're not feeling joyful, or you're not feeling happy, that's just a sign. It's just an indicator that you're not lined up with who you truly are, right? It's that massive, beautiful, invisible emotional guidance system that tells you when you need to reach for love again. That's all it's doing, right? That's what feeling bad tells you about, that you just need to choose love again. Yeah. We'll talk more about this, guys. This is Tom Karen with the Be Something Wonderful Studio of Higher Consciousness, where we help you level up and become the best version of yourself. Don't forget to subscribe, hit the notification bell, and share and like our videos. That's how we get our message out. With great love, this is Tom at Be Something Wonderful. Until next time.